Hey there, Brian here at my bench, and I'm ready to start the rigging on the Tuna Clipper kit. Now, I've never done any kind of rigging before, real or imaginary, and even the models I've seen in museums, I've never paid any real attention to the rope work other than just looking in amazement at the details. So this is going to be an entirely new experience for me, and I've been researching the best way to start, but nothing, you know. You would think the instructions would be somewhat clear, but no, I mean, really, they're not helpful at all. It shows where the lines and cables should go, but has nothing in the way of directions other than, well, let me just read it here. Study the drawings and follow the arrows to help in rigging your model. That's it. Nothing else. So, I mean, if you look on the model, the drawing shows the line going from here to here to here to here and then to here and to here and back to here, but it doesn't necessarily say which one you do first. As a matter of fact, it doesn't say anything about which one you do first, and it's supposed to be one long continuous cable that goes to all these points, so it's just threaded through it. And also the mast, there's the cables that run from the deck, and these, I'm assuming these are something similar to a turnbuckle, but I don't know. If they've got a name, I'd appreciate it if you leave it in the comments, because I don't know the name of these, and I don't know what the name of the cables are that run from the mast down to the deck. I do know that the rope ladders that go up, so you can climb up to the top of the mast, that are called ratlines, but that's about it. So I'm learning, and I hope you're gonna join me as I learn. Maybe you'll learn something too.
It's time just to think which one of these I wanted to tackle first, because I think these from the we'll keep calling them turnbuckles because I don't know any different. From the turnbuckles up to the top of the mast, I think I'm going to start with those, and I believe I'm going to do them all the way across. There's an eyelet right up here, so I should be able to run three lines from top down, and from here back up and back down again, and we'll see if I can tie a knot. I've got, what I'm using is a very thin thread. I chose gray because the age of this boat, it's a fairly modern boat, and I'm assuming, and again, this is an assumption on my part, so correct me if I'm wrong, I'm assuming that these cables here in modern day would probably be steel. Of course, they would have to be painted, so I don't know. So we're gonna start with some gray thread, and just to see how it goes. Maybe a complete bust, but we'll see. All right, here we go. That'll work. I'm just looking though. That's going to need holes in it also when the time comes. I don't know. Can't hardly see the thread. Okay. tied my first knot. Better do it again. You can see that, but as I'm tying each of these little overhand knots, it's creating a what looks like a cable tie, I guess, if you will. Yeah, adding some dimension to that knot. I'm gonna do it like maybe 2-3 more times. I'm gonna put just a dab of super glue on that before I let go, before I cut that off. Well, I don't know if I wanted this. Super glue may not have been a good idea. I'm gonna have to take it off and redo it. Side to side. I think that's what I need to do. It's not tight enough. Appropriate. Except that it's loose. Cutting it off, starting over.
We got some rigging thread now, and this is, I think, much more appropriate gauge for the scale of this ship. Back to the instructions. Start on the rigging for the mast and see how far we get. We need 3 strands. I wonder if I can get 3. I'm going to start this with the same method that I had going for the one, but I'm going to pull a little extra out so I've got some room to work with.
So there's three holes there now. I can put another hole. So we've got that one. Break anything more while I'm doing this. I think cotton would have been a better material for this than this is probably polyester. Doesn't cinch, it doesn't catch on itself very well. Burn it off at the knot. Start again. I gotta cut that mess off of there. Debonder. It may melt the plastic too. I don't know. We'll see. That'll never hold back on there. I'll never get that back. That's going to be ugly. Let's work on the other side while we let that dry. It's not pretty, but once I get some paint back on it, I think it'll look okay. Although I'm not super pleased with myself on that one. Let's see if we can get some string on this side over here. That's about as good as it's gonna get. That's but ugly, isn't it? Okay.
Okay.
So, it's on there. It's not the prettiest job, but it's there. And I get to go back and add back all the little bits and pieces I've broken off in the process. But, yeah, I'm actually pleased with that. So, cool. It's worth the wait.
Thank you very much for getting to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. I had fun with this one. If you're interested, the playlist is on the left, and the next video is on the right, and that's going to be, when it's ready, that's going to be weathering. You know, so subscribe. That way you'll know when it's posted. Okay, bye.